Hello, it's my rankings of all UK Eurovision entries, places 17 to 13. Welcome to Matt Loves Eurovision. Please do click on the subscribe button and that notification bell, and do please like, share and comment below. So in this batch of entries in my rankings, we are going through the sort of the teens positions, so very high up in the rankings. And as befits such high placings, all of these entries achieved at least a top four result at their respective Eurovisions. It's also quite a varied bunch in terms of decades, where we have four different decades represented in these five songs, which I like to think shows the kind of breadth and depth of our strength of UK entries over most of Eurovision's history. Start with 17. It's 1971's entry, Clodagh Rodgers, Jack in the Box.
I'm just your Jack in the Box, you know it ever. I'm gonna bounce up and down on the string. I tore your star when it stops, I'm just your Jack.
So Clodagh Rodgers was actually quite well known, in the UK at the time. She, interestingly enough, this was the first time that Eurovision was being held in the Republic of Ireland. And Clodagh Rodgers is actually Northern Irish, and she's Catholic Northern Irish as well. Now there were some, I think, possible threats against her at the time from the IRA, but fortunately all passed off okay. And I think what we probably remember most from, aside from being a very bubbly song and very catchy, which is hence why it's so high in my rankings, is the hot pants that she wore, which were, I think, kind of the epitome of kind of where fashion had been, or women's fashion had been going in the 60s and 70s. So you suddenly notice as you go into the 70s, suddenly the dresses plunge again down to the ankle, but not in 1971. This was Clodagh Rodgers' kind of biggest hit and one of her last big hits, but she went on to do quite a few other things in kind of musicals and in TV. She was an impressionist as well, sort of comedian as well. This did quite well in the UK charts as well, finishing fourth, and it finished fourth at 1971's Eurovision as well. Number 16, 1985, Vicky, Love Is. This is a little bit of an underrated, or perhaps almost half forgotten entry, but it was the best result the UK had during the mid-80s, sort of between 1981 and 1988, the win and Scottish Fitzgerald finishing second in 88, and finishing a very good, sort of respectable fourth place. It's a sort of catchy, up-tempo pop ballad, which I really enjoy. Vicky herself has now known as Aeon, or Aeoni, and specialises in New Age music and lives in the US, although she's done a lot of work composing music for movie trailers, I understand. I think the, as well as the sort of good song, I think the thing you probably is worth noting about this entry is the, what I like to call the chairography. If you watch the video the full video, you'll see that Vicky kind of starts on a chair and she stands up and dances around the chair, just a single chair as well. So I think chairography is how I'd like to describe that dance move. At 15, it's 1965, Kathy Kirby, I Belong. This is a great, sort of, you know, a very contemporary 60s pop song sung by Kathy Kirby, who I think bears many similarities in some ways in terms of her singing style and the type of music she sung to Cilla Black. Although sadly this was her kind of last, last big hit. She had a very, how should we say, exciting or interesting personal life in the sort of the decades that followed, particularly the 1970s. She retired from the music business in 1983 and died in 2011. But I think this is a great example of what the UK did at Eurovision in the 60s, actually brought contemporary pop songs as opposed to all the big kind of chansons, and it did very well. It finished in second place. I think by that point, that was the UK's fifth time as runners up. But it was the year that we had France Gall's Poupée de Cire, Poupée de Sang, which was even more exciting and contemporary. So it just fell short, but it's well worthy of a high place in my rankings. At 14 is 2002, Jessica Garlick, Come Back. This was the UK's, or is still the UK's, best result in the 21st century from Welsh singer Jessica Garlick. And it's a great, very well sung, big, sort of, you know, big pop ballad. And finishing a very good third, the last time the UK finished as high as that. It's not finished as high since, although we obviously got fifth in 2000 and 2009. And I suppose in some ways, at the time, perhaps it felt like, oh, this was a return to form after a couple of 2 or 3 years where the UK hadn't done as well as we'd expected. Sadly, it turns out this wasn't so much a return to form after a blip, but actually this was the blip and was the swan song of the UK's results. And I think it's worth saying that this result was achieved on 100% televote. So don't let everyone tell you that, oh, no one likes us. And they won't vote for us. That's rubbish. If you have a good song and a good singer, people do vote for you. And I personally think that this and also the song that finished second were much better than the winner in that year of 2002. Jessica hasn't really been seen much since this. I think she's, you know, married, had a family, and I think that's been her main focus. And she has come back for a couple of events, I think. But it'd be nice to see her, perhaps, again. I imagine her children are starting to be almost grown up now, so perhaps it'd be nice to see her back on the circuit, on the Eurovision circuit soon. At number 13, 1973, Cliff Richard, Power to All Our Friends. To the boys who play rock and roll, I made my life so sweet. And to the girls I knew before, and those I've yet to meet. Cliff Richard doesn't need a great deal of introduction, I think. He's actually just very recently celebrated his 80th birthday. And as I'm sure many of you probably know, this was his second entry at Eurovision after entering a few years earlier. I actually almost toyed with swapping these around. Perhaps this was the one that I preferred, but in the end, I placed this one 13th, and you'll see his other one a bit later on in the countdown. Really good 70s sort of pop song, very catchy. And I think it's fair to say with Cliff Richard, he is, I think, and I'm going to be, could be proved wrong, in terms of UK artists, he's probably the best selling artist that represented the UK. That's not to say that Eurovision songs were the best selling ones, but as an overall artist, he probably is the best selling one that has represented the UK, over 250 million records. Sold in his kind of his music in his career, and in the end, though, he didn't win Eurovision, and he came a good third here. 1973, I have to say, is probably one of the strongest years I can think of in terms of quality of songs, and so it really, really was tough. And I hope Eurovision again do 1973 sometime soon. This came third, finished, it got to fourth in the UK charts, and was actually a really big worldwide hit. So while it may not have won, it certainly had a lot of success. And I hope you've enjoyed that set of songs. Please do come and join me again when we'll be entering the top 10.